don't forget the doc. Several network participants recently called into Dr. Rick Wright's Old School Sundays radio show. Check this out.
And let's bring on Lee Keitt from New York City. Hey, Lee.
Yes, Dr. Wright.
How are you doing this afternoon, the superstar of Syracuse University?
Oh, Dr. Wright, first of all, happy Memorial Day to you.
Oh, happy Memorial Day to you on this incredible Memorial Day weekend, spectacular. And I've been mentioning the name of our Moses all day, Miss Harriet Tubman. And I call this the Harriet Tubman Spectacular Memorial Day weekend in the year 2010. And here you are getting ready to give us great information about Syracuse University. Go Orange, Lee Keitt.
Well, first, I just wanted to make sure that our servicemen and our veterans, we appreciate them and that they know that we're here.
Oh, God, yes. I had a chance and wonderful opportunity in my life to serve in two branches of the armed forces, the United States Army in the 1960s up into the early 70s, and then the United States Navy as a naval officer from 1981 to retirement in the year 2004, and happened to get lucky and go all the way to a captain rank in the United States Navy. So, go Navy on this Memorial Day weekend spectacular. But Lee, this is your time, man.
Dr. Wright.
Yes, Lee.
Network participant Verna Smith. Do you know Verna?
Oh, God, I've been knowing Verna for the next, what, last 33 years at least. And also taught her when she was in school in the S.I. Newhouse School of Public Communications at Syracuse University.
Well, she is running for Oprah Winfrey's search for the new TV star. Her category is traditional talk show.
Oh, Verna's good. She's super, man.
And I know that Verna hosted for several years her own cable show called Caribbean Roundtable. And now she builds herself and blog with the words Verna Smith, who puts the zip back in politics.
Oh, yes.
By the way, Verna is a former Network Advisory Board member, and we wish her the best. Dr. Wright.
Yes, Lee, talk to me, guy. Talk to me on this Memorial Day weekend spectacular.
As mentioned last week, the SU Washington, D.C. alumni are unleashing a networking barbecue. The new details are the date and location, Saturday, July the 17th, 12 p.m. at Burba Lake Park, Fort Meade, Maryland. There's more to come. Stay tuned, because I'm told that this is only the last day of a 3-day alumni reunion. Dr. Wright!
Oh, yes, Lee. Talk to us, man. Talk to us.
Networking Unleashed in the ATL will be on June the 13th at the home of SU alumni trustee and network participant Anthony B. Fulton. This networking opportunity will allow local Atlanta alums to meet and greet. I will be there, and maybe some of our FraserNet friends will want to stop by if they're still in town, because FraserNet Power Networking Conference ends the day before. Anyone interested should email me at kittcom@gmail.com. That's kittcom@gmail.com. Dr. Wright!
Hey, keep it coming, Lee. Keep the good information coming, man.
Are you actively performing in any role in Juneteenth this year?
Oh, yes. I've been actively involved as the master of ceremonies for our Juneteenth celebration from Clinton Square in the main stage for a number of years now. I look forward to it every year. So, yes, yours truly, Dr. Rick Wright, master of ceremonies for Juneteenth year 2010 from the main stage of the Clinton Square, historic Clinton Square, downtown Syracuse, New York. Yes.
Can you tell our network participants again, what is the historical importance of Juneteenth to the Syracuse community?
Well, to the Syracuse community in particular, and I've been mentioning Harriet Tubman's name all afternoon, but first of all, Juneteenth is a celebration of African-American freedom in America, and of course the date when the African-American slaves in Texas finally got the word that the Emancipation Proclamation from President Abraham Lincoln had basically freed all of the slaves, and the day they got the information was June 1865. And That was kind of late, man. They didn't have any internet or cell phones in those days, and our folks celebrated Juneteenth. Of course, this has been a hotbed of the abolitionist movement, the Jerry Rescue here in Syracuse, historic Clinton Square. In fact, you know, the only monument which celebrates really an African-American slave is here in Syracuse, or a former slave, and that is the Jerry Rescue Monument, which is in Clinton Square in downtown Syracuse, New York. And, of course, Frederick Douglass, you know, the North Star, and Bishop Jermain Wesley Logan, who was the first pastor of the People's African Methodist Episcopal Zion Church here in the city of Syracuse. All great abolitionists. Reverend Samuel May. Oh, the list goes on and on in Syracuse's connection to Juneteenth. And, of course, a lot of this happened, you know, before even the American Civil War and the Underground Railroad.
Wow. Dr. Wright.
Yes, Lee. I'm listening, man.
This is our last item.
Okay, last item.
Sad news. The network expresses its condolences to the family of Richard T. Bull's class of 1973.
Yes.
Richard recently passed away. Do you know of his relevancy to Syracuse University and the Syracuse Eight?
Richard Bowles was one of the football, African-American football stars of the early 1970s, the late 1960s, that boycotted the Syracuse University football team, basically asking for four demands: the hiring of an assistant African-American coach, better tutoring to help them with their classes, better medical care, and to be selected to play in various positions on the football team based on ability. And all of these brothers, along with John Lobo, man, and all of them, were incredible football players in the lineage of Syracuse University Orange football. And they laid the table and laid the stage for greatness to occur further at Syracuse University. So God bless the soul of Orange great, Syracuse football great, Mr. Richard Bowles. God bless his soul. And thank God that we had Chancellor Nancy Cantor and her great leadership, and the great Dr. Darryl Gross, man, who brought them all back to celebrate their legacy a number of football seasons ago.
Anyone wishing to make comments concerning the life of Richard Bowles should log into the network virtual office. And to do that, all you have to do is go to www.officezilla.com. And use the username power1069, and the password is also power1069. Dr. Rick Wright, this is Lee Keitt for the network.
Okay, Lee Keitt from Superstar New York City, home of Fleet Week and this big-time Memorial Day spectacular. As we get to all the Syracuse University alums throughout the world, checking out Dr. Rick Wright, Power 106.9, Old School Sunday. On a big bad Sunday afternoon, Dr. Rick Wright, live and well in Syracuse here at Power 106.9 Radio. Do it.
The network reminds you that you too may call in to Dr. Rick Wright on Sundays between 1 p.m. and 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Check in with the doc at area code 315-428-1069. Don't forget the doc.